This sing-song morning ritual in the Telangana district of Andhra Pradesh has become a hauntingly familiar one. The impromptu, poetic lyrics, tribute to the dreams of yet another farmer forced to choose death over life. In Chebati village in Medak district, 30-year-old Srinivas leased out 6 acres to grow cotton. Last year, cotton had sold at over 6,000 rupees a quintal, and his father's half acre was inadequate to meet his debt of 3 lakh rupees. With 3 children and parents to take care of, he decided to take his chance. But the rains failed, and the once proud and confident young man hung himself. Srinu's young widow Balamma is 25. Their eldest daughter Monica has dropped out of school, so has Alekia. And it is likely that their son Anil will also be forced to leave the private English medium school where he is studying. A survey of some 1100 farmers who committed suicide in Medak district has shown that the average age of the farmer was hardly 32 years, most of them very young, tenant farmers, burdened with responsibilities far beyond what they thought they could fulfill. Srinu, for example, was hardly 30 years old, father of 3 children, married at 18. He had inherited only debt and loss from his father. Less than 5 kilometers away from Chebarti village in Alirajapeta in Medak district, Dacharam Vaikuntam killed himself after the cotton crop failed for the second year. 5-year-old Manoj reaches out to comfort his mother, who has 3 school-going children and a debt of 2 lakhs to tackle. Vaikuntam had leased out 4 acres, banking on the high price cotton fetched last year, even though he had to buy seeds in the black market, fertilizer prices doubled, and pesticide costs rose. The cash crop cotton, with its high input cost and market volatility, has spun a web of farmer suicide deaths in Andhra Pradesh and elsewhere in the country. With the price of cotton going up to 6,500 rupees per quintal last year, the area under cotton this year went up to 47 lakh acres. That is about 25% of the total sown area. A distressed situation was but expected, but the government completely failed to act to avert it. The irony is that BT cotton is celebrating 10 years of its introduction in India. Industry claims the genetically modified cotton has brought in a white gold revolution. India's cotton production has doubled from 2002 to 2008, and we are now the world's second largest producer and exporter. Around 60 lakh farmers grow BT cotton on 90% of India's total cotton area. And in states like Andhra Pradesh, only BT cotton is grown, also because no other seed is even available. And yet, it is cotton-growing farmers who account for most farmer suicides.
Both on technology front and solution front, we borrow from a situation which doesn't reflect us.
Senior scientist Ramanjanelu points out how every technology brought in as a solution spawned a problem. Synthetic pyrethroids became popular in the 80s to combat the American bollworm, but they destroyed the natural predators of the pest. Eventually, the insects developed resistance and the number of expensive sprays multiplied. This is when the first farmer suicide deaths were reported in 1987-88, when 37 farmers committed suicide in Guntur Prakasam. In the 90s, pesticide use reached a peak and cotton accounted for 65% of all the pesticide used in the country. Andhra Pradesh topped in the use of pesticides and fertilizers. Warangal turned suicide capital with 360 farmer suicide deaths reported in 1997-98. Genetically engineered BT cotton was introduced a decade ago to stop indiscriminate pesticide use. But that has not been an unqualified success story. Industry is now pushing double gene enhanced BT over the single gene BT seed. Yet, the suicide reports continue.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.